Fortunately, the cargo plane carrying 35 tons of Médecins Sans Frontières medical and logistics supplies managed to land last night at Kathmandu's overwhelmed airport.
We've offloaded 23 pallets of medical equipment and medicines and logistics supplies, everything to set up the inflatable hospital tent.
In the coming days, an MSF surgical team will be able to admit patients to the 20-bed inflatable field hospital.
MSF teams are offloading the cargo and are assessing an area northwest of Kathmandu, where the Ministry of Health have said needs are significant and that it would be a good place to set up the inflatable field hospital. While the logisticians are constructing the inflatable hospital, the surgical team has gone to support the Nepalese teams at the hospital in Bhaktapur.
This morning, at the hospital in Bhaktapur, we had to perform a fasciotomy on one patient, so removing damaged soft tissue. We had to treat another with burns on his lower limbs and one of his hands, and the last patient who had suffered injury to his foot.
Meanwhile, on Tuesday, another team carried out an aerial assessment in the district of Gorkha, an area northwest of Kathmandu, badly hit by the earthquake. Of the 65 villages seen, 45 are either partially or totally destroyed. Such assessments are carried out in order to set up mobile clinics and organise the distribution of essential items in remote areas. A mobile clinic team set out for the first time earlier today.
Kathmandu and Bhaktapur are easily accessible now. However, there are small mountain villages that have been destroyed, or even bigger towns, that are extremely difficult to access. Some can only be reached by helicopter, while it can take up to 7 hours on foot to reach others. With the Ministry of Health, we've decided to focus on peripheral areas as opposed to the big towns, where we can have a greater added value.